When you hear the term quiescent current, what is the first thing you think of? Standby current? Shutdown current? No load current? Sometimes it may seem like there is an entire lexicon just for quiescent current. But the truth is that each term relates to the same thing, the input current drawn by the IC from the input supply. However, different IC states impact the input current in different ways, which is why we have a glossary of terms for IQ. But in this video, we are just going to touch on the three most important quiescent current parameters that you will see in our datasheet: shutdown current, non-switching current, and no load input current. First, let's tackle shutdown current. This is measured when the IC is turned off or disabled. In theory, you might think that it should be zero, and it makes no sense to have a non-zero current measured when the IC is off. But in reality, some ICs exhibit leakage currents in this state, while others actually have internal circuitry that consumes a small amount of current to maintain housekeeping functions, even while the IC is disabled. Think of the camera on your phone. Though it is off most of the time, it is always drawing some power to be ready to quickly start up when you decide to take a picture. Shutdown current especially comes into play when we talk about shelf life. Think about a piece of electronics sitting on the shelf of a store. If it is connected to internal battery power, that non-zero shutdown current, called ship mode current in battery charger parlance, will drain that battery even while it is sitting on the shelf. And if it sits on the shelf too long with too high of a shutdown current, the customer will not be able to turn on the electronics when they take it out of the box. Now let's talk about non-switching current. This is when the IC is enabled and in between switching events. This parameter is found in most switching DC-DC datasheets because it can be easily tested on production automated test equipment. It's also a component of our next parameter, and one that is much more important for your real-world application: operating quiescent current. Operating quiescent current can be found under many different names: standby quiescent current, no-load input current, ground current, operating IQ, switching IQ, no-load IQ, sleep mode, and so on. All of these terms refer to the state when the device is enabled and regulating, but with zero load current. This no-load IQ value is really the closest you can get to the input current drawn in your application, but it is still far from perfect. Many applications utilize a standby mode, whereby the system is on and waiting for an action to be taken. Think of your battery-powered smart lock on your front door. It's only really drawing significant power when you are entering the code and it opens the lock. The other 99.99% of the time, it is in standby, waiting for an action to be taken. The power supply is not off. It is not disabled, but is on and regulating a voltage to keep the system alive, waiting for an entrant to appear. If the low power MCU code and other aspects of the entire system are designed to consume little power, then the no load IQ is likely a good estimate of your battery current consumption. For ultra low power devices, IC designers go to great lengths to eliminate every nanoamp of operating quiescent current by optimizing each individual circuit block to do its job on the least amount of current. By doing so, it's possible for some systems to go 10 years between battery changes when using the latest low IQ devices, compared to maybe 2 years when using the previous generation power supply IC. For more information about achieving low IQ with your power supply, visit ti.com/lowIQ.